China has quickly developed the world's largest naval force. In 2015, China had 255 battle force ships. Now they have more than 360. And many of those ships are more capable than anything in the American naval fleet. So how are we responding to this?
Some of it's relatively straightforward work, where we're making good progress designing body armor that fits women properly, tailoring combat uniforms for women, creating maternity flight suits, updating requirements for their hairstyles.
So we've got new hairstyles and maternity flight suits. Pregnant women are going to fight our wars. It's a mockery of the U.S. military.
Drama TV. Ladies and gentlemen, that's what I call it. I'll apologize up front and tell you that I don't have cable news at home. I don't have it here in the office, and I don't watch a lot of drama TV. I understand some comments were made yesterday, and I watched the clip that Mr. Carlson produced as he referred to pregnant women in the military. I'll remind everyone that his opinion, which he has a right to, is based off of actually 0 days of service in the armed forces. He was talking specifically about pregnant women in the armed forces today and how it makes us less lethal and less fit and less ready. Let me tell you where he's wrong. Those decisions were made by medical professionals, by commanders, and our civilian leadership that allows for women to have more time with their children, to recuperate, to get fit and ready, to take that time that's necessary that our medical professionals know is needed, which actually makes us a more lethal and ready and fit force. We value women in our armed forces. We value those that have served in the past, and we value those that have served today. We value our families in the military. Let's remember that those opinions were made by an individual who has never served a day in his life. Let's remember that's all about drama TV. God bless America. Semper Fidelis.
Today, the Department of Defense launched a large and coordinated public relations offensive against this show. Pentagon brass issued hostile statements. People in uniform sent out videos on social media. The DOD even issued a news release attacking us. Press Secretary smites Fox News host. Unless you have served in the military yourself, you haven't earned that right. Really? Can only cops talk about police brutality? If you haven't been elected to office, are you allowed to criticize Congress? They're not making a real argument. They're trying to silence dissent. Not playing along. Sorry. If the Pentagon can show that pregnant pilots are the best, we will be the first to demand an entire Air Force of pregnant pilots. Finding the most effective military pilots or infantry officers or SEAL teams is not his priority. It's not even close to his priority. Identity politics is Joe Biden's priority. It's all that matters. Just this week, the Biden administration announced that the Pentagon will pay for gender reassignment surgery for active duty personnel. How do sex changes in the military make this country safer?